When we made the decision to close the hospital, I had no idea at that point in time how complex it was going to be. It's easier to open a hospital than it is to close it. One of our biggest challenges has been the hospital converted to an electronic medical record 6 or 7 years ago, maybe 8 years ago. But prior to that, everything was paper record. These are all health protected information records that have to be shredded. They can't be thrown away. And most of these are charts that have been scanned. So this is a patient chart. And this is what they looked like before we had a computer. Pages and pages and pages of nurses' notes. When you close a hospital, you have to be responsible for every patient who ever was served there being able to have access to that paper record, or you have to digitize it and have access. So poor Connie, out there at the desk, that's all she does. She sits there all day long and scans.
Up until Monday, we had 5 of us scanning, and we've been scanning every day as fast as we can scan since September. And it's took us all this time to get what we, and like I say, we're still finding some stuff now that have to be done.
We have shredded, I think, somewhere in the neighborhood of probably 400 or 500 banker's boxes full of records that have been now digitized. So we're trying to sell off anything that is usable, that people can take and they can use it for some other purpose. And we have been, I've been hugely surprised by cabinets and shelving and all kinds of casework that people are willing to buy and take off and repurpose. Every garage in Osceola now has, I think, one of my cabinets in it. It's good.
I've been here 34 years. My daughter was born here. She's 34 now. Yeah, she's 34. Very sad. Loss for the community. We employed 1/10 of the population, and we've lost that.
But I don't think it was salvageable. The payer mix was terrible. It was Medicare, Medicaid, and self-pay, and we had 15% commercial insurance. And you just can't survive in that kind of an environment. So every month we ran at a deficit. A good month we only lost $20,000. Some months we lost $100,000 or $200,000, just depending.
Well, for years we've been struggling, you know, to stay open, just because, I mean, it was just, every year it got a little harder. It's probably been, what, 7, 8 years that we've had a raise, because, you know, if we thought that would help, you know.
Somebody told us that we would never close, because a hospital never closes. So we had that in our hearts something might happen, but.
They just started cutting people a little at a time. And, but like Carolyn, they kept saying, you can't close a hospital, you know, but we found out that's not true.
I think the hardest thing has been the emotional impact on the staff who worked here for 30 and 40 years.
The most wonderful place there ever could be to work. And the people you work with. And it's hard to say. It's hard to say goodbye.
Our patients were families. Everybody, you know, most of the patients we had here was family or neighbors, or we got to know them as family.
In a great big hospital, you're just another patient. Here, you're special. You're part of the family. And so I think that is something that the hospital provided that you don't see in a lot of places.